So in the last lecture, we have discussed how to do naming for the alkyl substituents if they are complex. If they are not easy, like methane से आपको directly methyl मिलेगा, ethane से ethyl मिलेगा, propane से आपको two types of substituents बन सकता है, one by replacing hydrogen on the first carbon and by replacing hydrogen on the second carbon. On the first carbon you will be getting propyl, on the second carbon you are getting, whenever you are having any alkyl group attached to the parent chain, you need to start numbering from the carbon where there is a branch. So is particular carbon se aapko numbering karna padega, this will be 1, this is 2. So yaha pe aapko methyl group hai, this is 1 methyl ethyl. From the butane you can have two different substituents from n-butane. N-butane matlab straight chain mein carbon atoms hai, so it is called as n-butane. So this is butyl. And यहाँ पे आपको 1, 2, 3 on the first carbon you are having methyl, hence it is 1-methylpropyl, or I can also call this as on the first carbon आपको methyl group है, hence it is called as secondary. This is secondary butyl. So on so forth देखा हमने. You are having some common names like secondary, tertiary, iso and neo. Secondary is that particular group which has 1-methyl group on the first carbon, and rest of the carbon chain has to be straight chain. There should not be any branches. Tertiary is that particular substituent which has 2-methyl groups on the first carbon, and you should not have any branches in the rest of the carbon chain. Iso matlab, if you are having 1-methyl group on the second last carbon, it is called as iso, with no branches on the remaining of the carbon chain. If you are having 2-methyl groups on the second last carbon, it is called as neo, again no branches on the remaining carbon chain. उसके बाद हमने कुछ क्वेश्चंस किया है. We have seen these two questions. I hope ये दो क्वेश्चंस में आपको कुछ डाउट नहीं है. इस क्वेश्चन में स्टार्टिंग में आप लोग ने, आप में से एक ने दोनों प्रोपाइल करके बात कर लिया. प्लीज ऑब्जर्व दैट दिस इज अ प्रोपाइल बट दिस इज नॉट प्रोपाइल. इवन दो इट हैज 3 कार्बन, दिस इज नॉट द रेगुलर प्रोपाइल. ओके, सो इसी के लिए हमने ये सब बात किया. So C for the carbon which is directly attached to the parent chain, उसके बाद numbering करो, then you write the name. This is 1-methyl ethyl. As you are having separate numbering in the branch, you need to put that in bracket. इस particular substituent को bracket में रखना पड़ेगा, because you are having separate numbering inside this. Is that clear? Okay, everyone. ठीक है, next. Corollary to the longest chain rule, if there happens to be two chains of equal length, select that chain which has greater number of branches. Okay, suppose a particular organic molecule mein you are having two chains and both the chains are having greater number of carbon atoms. Us context mein you will be selecting that particular chain which has more number of branches. Is case mein dekho, you are having two chains, chain A as well as chain B. For chain A, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 carbon atoms, and the number of substituents are ax substituent hoga and ye wala bada ax substituent hoga. You are having 3 substituents for chain A. If you are taking chain B, ye wala chain, iske liye substituents kitna ho raha hai? Chain B is this chain. Okay, is chain ke liye substituents kitna hai? 1, 2, 3, 4. As you are having 4 substituents, select chain B. Chain A ke liye you are having only 3 substituents. Okay, A kab use karna hai? If you are having two long chains with same number of carbon atoms, select that particular chain which has greater number of branches. Theek hai, ab isme numbering kaise karna hai? If you are doing from left to right, in that case 1, 2, 3 on the third carbon you are getting a branch. If you are doing from right to left, 1, 2 on the second carbon you are getting the branch. So 2 is always better when compared to 3. Bas ho gaya, you need to compare the first number with the first number. If there is a difference, you will be selecting that particular branch. Is that clear? Agar tie hua to you need to go for the next number, wahan pe bhi tie hua to next number, so on so forth. Okay, if they are in equivalent positions, matlab if all the branches are in equivalent positions. Equivalent positions ka matlab kya hai? लेफ्ट टू राइट से जो नंबरिंग आ रहा है, राइट टू लेफ्ट से भी वही नंबरिंग आ रहा है. इन दैट केस व्हाट यू नीड टू डू, यू नीड टू गो फॉर द अल्फाबेटिकल लिस्टिंग. द वन व्हिच कम्स इन अल्फाबेट फर्स्ट इन अल्फाबेटिकल लिस्टिंग, उसको ज्यादा प्रायोरिटी देके उस साइड से नंबरिंग स्टार्ट करेंगे. ओके, गुड, वेरी गुड. सो दिस विल बी the branches are, this is methyl and this is propyl. So it is 2, 3, 5 trimethyl and 4 propyl heptane. Any doubt? Okay, please do naming for this compound fast. First, you need to select the longest carbon chain. Longest carbon chain is one which has greater number of carbon atoms. If you are having two carbon chains with same number of carbon atoms, you need to go for that particular carbon chain which has more number of branches. I hope most of you got this printout liya to usme karna aapko zyada better rahega, printout le lena. Believe me, do this organic sincerely. Har ek lecture mein 100% do apna. At the end of the organic chemistry, you will be most happy students in India. Okay, kuch kuch rahenge, मेजर चंक हो जाएगा, थ्योरी भी अच्छा रहता है ऑर्गेनिक.
सो
या अच्छा बताओ,
फाइव नियो पेंटाइल नोनेन.
ओके गुड, बाकी लोग जी आया या कुछ अलग आया?
सेम आया.
Same, yeah. Good. यहाँ पे आपको I don't think you have two carbon chains with equal number of carbon atoms. I think you have only one carbon chain which has greater number of carbon atoms. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. इसमें 9 है. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. इसमें तो 8 ही है ना. So this is the carbon chain which is having greater number of carbon atoms. So इसको भी parent chain लेंगे. And you can number this from left to right or right to left, correct nahi padega, because you are having 5 on the branch. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. This is the parent chain. If you don't want to write that in terms of common name, aapko karna kya padega? You need to do separate numbering here. This will be 1, 2, 3. So the name of the branch, first identify the name of the branch. उसके बाद यू कैन ऐड दैट टू द एक्चुअल नेम. दिस विल बी 2, 2 डाइमिथाइल
प्रोपाइल.
गुड, 2, 2 डाइमिथाइल प्रोपाइल. सो इसका ओवरऑल नेम क्या हो जाएगा? दिस इज 5, 2, 2 डाइमिथाइल प्रोपाइल. आपके पास कार्बन से इसलिए नॉन एन. ओके, और यू कैन आल्सो राइट दिस एज दिस इज आल्सो कॉल्ड एज नियो पेंटाइल बिकॉज़ यू आर हैविंग टू मेटल ग्रुप्स ऑन द सेकंड लास्ट कार्बन, नियो पेंटाइल. सो द अदर नेम वुड बी 5 नियो पेंटाइल नॉन एन. You need to know how to write both the names, matlab all the possible existing names. Reason, this question may come in more than one of the questions in your JEE Advanced. Tab aapko sare possible names pata hona chahiye. Okay? Okay. Mark answer for these two questions. Okay, answer.
So 5 bracket में 2 ethyl butyl, then 3.3 dimethyl decane.
Very good. सही है. Very good. इसमें क्या हो रहा है? You are having this particular carbon chain, which is having 10 carbons. You are having this particular carbon chain, which is also having 10 carbons. If I am taking this carbon chain, the one which is marked in green box, okay, उसके लिए number of substituents कितना हुआ? ये एक substituent हुआ और ये वाला एक substituent हुआ. You are having only 2 substituents. If I am taking this particular carbon chain, which is also having 10 carbons, आपको 1, 2, and 3, you are having 3 substituents. Okay, total of 3. Three substituents. So इसको आपको select करना पड़ेगा. इसको select करते समय again you need to do numbering in such a way so that the branches will get lowest possible numbers. So यहाँ पे आपको 1 आएगा, ये 2, this will be 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. उसके बाद write the name of the substituents. This substituent is methyl. एंड ये वाला सब्स्टिट्यूएंट, इसका अलग नंबरिंग करना पड़ेगा आपको. 1, 2, 3, 4. सो दिस सब्स्टिट्यूएंट इज 2 इथाइल ब्यूटाइल, विच कम्स फर्स्ट इन अल्फाबेटिकल लिस्टिंग. ई कम्स फर्स्ट व्हेन कंपेयर्ड टू एम. सो इसलिए आपको नेमिंग में, फाइनल नेम में, यू विल गेट दिस एज 5 ब्रैकेट में 2 ethyl butyl, okay, and 3.3 dimethyl decane. Any doubt, anyone? Sab logo clear hai na? Just see for the carbon chain which has more number of branches. Once you identify that, first try to get the name of the branch. उसके बाद पूरा नेम लिख सकते हो आप लोग. सो ये वाला ब्रांच तो मिथाइल हो गया, ये वाला ब्रांच थोड़ा कॉम्प्लेक्स है. सो स्टार्ट नंबरिंग फ्रॉम हियर, 1, 2, 3, 4. सो ऑन द सेकंड कार्बन यू आर हैविंग इथाइल, सो इट इज 2 इथाइल ब्यूटाइल. एज ई कम्स फर्स्ट, आई एम पुटिंग दिस फर्स्ट एंड कंपेयर टू मिथाइल. सो 5 2 इथाइल ब्यूटाइल, 3.3 डाइमिथाइल डेकेन. ओके, नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन का आंसर अगर इनकेस हो गया तो. You don't have any common name for this because they are having ethyl part. You need to have only one carbon on the first carbon and on the second last carbon. Moreover, a second carbon ke upar hai, so there is no common name.
सर,
या
4 ब्रैकेट में 1 मिथाइल इथाइल, देन 5 ब्रैकेट में 1 मिथाइल प्रोपाइल डेकेन.
ओके, वो एक नेम हुआ. डू यू हैव एनी अदर पॉसिबल नेम? दैट्स वन नेम, एब्सोल्युटली राइट. और कोई नेम, एनी अदर स्टूडेंट? Can you write this in terms of common name? Do you have any common name for those substituents? Jayesh?
Yes.
Can you tell me any common names of the substituents? First of all, ye sab log ko clarity aa gaya hoga. This is the parent chain and you need to do numbering from left to right. 3, 4, yahan pe 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. You are having this as one substituent. ये एक substituent हुआ आपको, and ये another substituent हुआ. Jayesh, can you tell me any common name that is possible for the substituent?
Sec propyl.
Very good. Secondary propyl, but secondary propyl करके नहीं लिखते इसको. IUPAC में हमने isopropyl करके fix किया. You are having the methyl group on the first carbon as well as on the second last carbon. Very important. आपको कभी भी secondary propyl कोई भी question paper में दिखेगा ही नहीं, कोई भी literature paper में भी नहीं दिखेगा. you need to call this as isopropyl. एक तो isopropyl हुआ उसका नाम. Any other name? If you are doing numbering, ये 1, 2 होगा, so this will be 1-methyl.
Ethyl.
Okay. इसके लिए अगर numbering करके कर रहे तो ये 1, 2, 3 होगा, this will be 1-methyl. Propyl. Okay. Common name.
Isobutyl.
अभी इसमें आइसो नहीं, अभी इसमें आइसो नहीं जयेश. On the first carbon you are having methyl. Second last carbon के ऊपर methyl रहता तो ऐसे बोलते. इसमें क्या हुआ, first carbon के ऊपर जैसा ही हो रहा है, second last carbon के ऊपर भी जैसा हो रहा है. So secondary और ऐसे दोनों बोल सकता हूँ. Secondary को हटा के हम ऐसो fix किया. इस केस में on the first carbon you are having a methyl, so secondary कहेंगे. Second last carbon के ऊपर नहीं है. Okay. So this will be called as secondary
butyl.
Okay. So if you are writing the name in terms of common name, dono branches ke liye common name hai na. So if you are using isopropyl for this, you need to use secondary butyl for this. Aisa nahi karna hai. Isko common name choose kiya, isko 1-methyl propyl use kiya. This is not a good system. Dono ko common names mein likho ya dono ko systematic naming mein likho. एक को कॉमन नेम, एक को सिस्टमैटिक नेम, क्योंकि दोनों के एग्जिस्ट हो रहे कॉमन नेम, इसलिए. सो व्हाट यू विल राइट, यू कैन राइट दिस एज, ओके, इफ आई एम राइटिंग दिस इन टर्म्स ऑफ कॉमन नेम, यहाँ पे आई के साथ स्टार्ट हो रहा है, यहाँ पे सेकेंडरी में एस नहीं कंसिडर करना है आपको, बी कंसिडर करना है. इन अल्फाबेटिकल लिस्टिंग यू शुड नॉट कंसिडर एस, राइट. सो इफ यू आर कंसिडरिंग बी, बी कम्स फर्स्ट व्हेन कंपेयर्ड टू आई. So this will be 5 secondary butyl. Batao, 5 secondary butyl.
4 isopropyl.
4 isopropyl.
Decane.
Decane. Very good. Okay, Bhargav, dusra name bata dena. Bhargav.
Yes, sir.
Ha.
4 ब्रैकेट में 1-methyl-ethyl.
वेरी गुड, वेरी गुड. 4 1-methyl
ethyl. 5 इन ब्रैकेट 1-methyl-propyl.
5
1-methyl-propyl.
1-methyl-propyl.
Decane.
Okay. Whenever you are having numbers ना, numbers को ये सेपरेट करने के लिए यू विल बी यूजिंग हाइफन. ओके, ये हाइफन आपको क्यों लगा रहा हूँ समझ में आना चाहिए. क्लियर है? ठीक है. यहाँ पे मिथाइल इथाइल पहले लिखा क्योंकि एपी एम से स्टार्ट हो रहे हैं, यहाँ पे भी एम से स्टार्ट हो रहे हैं, सो इसलिए नेक्स्ट अल्फाबेट लिखा. यहाँ पे ई है, यहाँ पे पी है. ई कम्स फर्स्ट, इसलिए 1-methyl इथाइल को पहले लिखा. 4 1-methyl इथाइल, 5 1-methyl प्रोपाइल. Okay, so let's add functional groups into the organic compound and let us see how to name them. Okay, अब तक हमने जो भी naming देखा, these are for simple hydrocarbons and in hydrocarbons में भी हमने alkenes का ही ज्यादा लिखा. Alkenes और alkenes को ज्यादा include नहीं किया. Alkenes और alkenes को include करते हुए बाद में लिखेंगे, don't worry. But now we have seen nomenclature for simple hydrocarbons, and if you are having some complex substituents, if the alkyl group is not a simple alkyl group, how to name that alkyl group? ये देखा हमने. Let us see how to name functional groups. First of all, let us understand what is meant by a functional group. A functional group is nothing but a single atom or a group of atoms because of which the molecule's properties, the properties are physical and chemical properties, will be changed. Different different functional groups ke wajah se unke chemical property. What is meant by chemical property? First of all, it is nothing but whenever I am reacting that particular molecule with a specific reagent, the type of reaction which we will have. Okay, if I am having different functional groups, those different functional groups with the same reagent can have different reaction. and that is based on the property of the functional group. So a functional group is nothing but that particular group which determines the chemical characteristics or the physical properties of the compound. Okay. कार्बन चेन के अलावा कुछ अलग दिखा तो इट विल बी कॉल्ड एज अ फंक्शनल ग्रुप. इज दैट क्लियर? ओके. ए फंक्शनल ग्रुप इज एन एटम और ए ग्रुप ऑफ एटम्स व्हिच कैरेक्टराइजेस द केमिकल रिएक्टिविटी ऑफ द मॉलिक्यूल द लॉन्गेस्ट चेन ऑफ एटम. सो व्हेनेवर यू आर हैविंग द फंक्शनल ग्रुप इन जनरल वी विल ट्राई टू इंक्लूड दैट पर्टिकुलर फंक्शनल ग्रुप इन द लॉन्गेस्ट चेन. इफ वी आर अनेबल टू इंक्लूड इट वी विल मेक श्योर दैट द पर्टिकुलर फंक्शनल ग्रुप इज हैविंग लोएस्ट पॉसिबल नंबर. दो केसेस हो सकता है. एक तो हम कंपलसरी उसको इंक्लूड कर लेंगे अगर इंक्लूड कर पा रहे तो. वी विल सी व्हाट डू आई मीन बाय वी आर अनेबल टू इंक्लूड इट. देखते हैं उसका मतलब क्या है. ओके. ए लॉन्गेस्ट चेन ऑफ एटम्स कंटेनिंग द फंक्शनल ग्रुप्स इज नंबर्ड इन सच ए वे सो दैट द कार्बन टू विच द फंक्शनल ग्रुप इज अटैच्ड इज असाइंड द लोएस्ट पॉसिबल नंबर. क्लियर? फंक्शनल ग्रुप को ज्यादा प्रायोरिटी देना चाहिए आपको. उसको लोएस्ट पॉसिबल नंबर आना है. लोएस्ट पॉसिबल नंबर आना है इसका मतलब ये नहीं है जहां पे फंक्शनल ग्रुप है उस पर नंबर वन दूंगा. ओके. इट इज नॉट नेसेसरी दैट इट शुड गेट द नंबर वन. क्योंकि बहुत सारे बच्चों को ये कंफ्यूजन आता है जहां पे फंक्शनल ग्रुप रहता है दे विल बी स्टार्टिंग दैट पर्टिकुलर कार्बन एज वन. ये नहीं करना है. ये जरूरत नहीं है. यू नीड टू गेट लोएस्ट पॉसिबल नंबर फॉर द फंक्शनल ग्रुप. You will always select the longest possible chain. Once you select the longest possible chain, you need to see for the position of the functional group. You need to make sure that the functional group is getting lowest possible number. Is that clear? Okay. जब questions करेंगे और clarity आएगा आपको. If you are having more than one functional group in the compound, in case of polyfunctional compounds, one of the functional group is chosen as principal functional group. And the compound is named treating the other groups as substituents. Okay. मतलब क्या है? कभी-कभी compounds में you can have more than one functional group. मतलब carboxylic acid भी रह सकता है उसके अंदर, ketone भी रह सकता है. What is the IUPAC template? The IUPAC template is you have prefix, you have compound root, and you have suffix. In the prefix, you will be naming the substituents. In the compound root, you will be naming the length of the carbon chain. In the suffix, you will be naming the unsaturation index if it is an alkene or an alkyne, followed by the functional group. You need to name only one functional group in the suffix. If you are having more than one functional group, ek functional group ko hum primary or principal functional group manenge. The one which is treated as the primary or principal functional group, that is named in the suffix. Okay. Rest all other functional groups will definitely be named in the prefix. Matlab, they will be named as substituents. Accordingly, we have two different names. Matlab kya hai? Koi bhi ek functional group ko, if I'm writing that in suffix, ek tarike se likhenge. If I'm writing the same functional group in prefix, I will be writing that in a different way. Do names rahega usko. One, if it is the principal functional group, it will be present in the suffix and it will be named in one particular way. Iska matlab kya hai? Dikhaunga aapko. And the other, if it is not the principal functional group, it is treated as a substituent. Hence, you will be naming that in the prefix. Clear hai? Okay. Everyone, I hope they are in the lecture. If you are having polyfunctional compounds, if you are having only one group, that particular group will be the principal functional group, which is named in the suffix. If you are having more than one group, the rest of the groups will be named as substituents. And they will be present in the prefix. Any doubt? Good to go? Okay. देखो, different इस table आपको बहुत important है. इस table में आपको मैं 2 minutes, sorry. ये जो particular table है, this table is very very important. You need to remember the entire table. If you are unable to remember at the first go, जब भी आप लोग questions करेंगे ना, तब समझ में आ जाएगा. You need to refer to this table again and again, so you will remember things. If you are having acid halide, सबसे पहले आपको you need to know what is the general representation of the functional group. Acid halide के लिए general representation is C double bond OX. इस particular यहाँ पे आप लोग क्या करेंगे? You will be marking R, which is nothing but the parent chain. okay, RC double bond OXL. This is the acid halide. Again, I have written two different ways of naming. कुछ तो रिप्रेजेंटेशन किया, इसको ब्रैकेट में रखा, इसको यहाँ पे कुछ ब्रैकेट नहीं रखा. इफ देर इज नो ब्रैकेट एंड इफ दिस इज द प्रिंसिपल फंक्शनल ग्रुप, इन द सफिक्स इट्स नेम विल बी कार्बोनिल हैलाइड. ओके, इससे पहले क्या आएगा? कार्बोनिल हैलाइड इज द नेम ऑफ द फंक्शनल ग्रुप. इससे पहले क्या आएगा आपको? यू विल बी हैविंग द अनसैचुरेशन इंडेक्स. उससे पहले यू विल बी हैविंग द कंपाउंड रूट. उससे पहले यू विल बी हैविंग द प्रीफिक्स. This is nothing but the suffix. You will be ending that particular molecule with carbonyl halide. C double bond O. In general, it is called as carbonyl. उसके ऊपर X attach किया मैंने, hence it is called as carbonyl halide. Okay. The other type of naming is कुछ तो bracket लिखा. उस case में in the suffix it is called as oil halide. इसका मतलब क्या है? एक चीज का मैं एक्सप्लेन कर रहा हूं, एक ही एग्जांपल, इसके लिए एग्जांपल दे रहा हूं.
सर,
या
अगर वो प्रिंसिपल चेन में आ रहा है तो सिर्फ प्रीफिक्स लगाएंगे ना, सफिक्स नहीं?
तो सफिक्स नहीं होगा. इसका मतलब क्या है सर? प्रिंसिपल में आ रहे तो सफिक्स में करेंगे, प्रीफिक्स नहीं लगाएंगे. If it is not the principle, then it will be in the form of prefix. मैं यहाँ पे ये लिखा, if we are having more than one functional group, then this will be written in the prefix. If it is the secondary functional group, if it is not the primary functional group, in the prefix it is named as halocarbonyl. समझ में आएगा आपको? Whenever we do question, तब समझ में आएगा. अभी के लिए एक example देता हूँ, बस उतना ही देखो. If I have this particular molecule, CH3. CH2 C double bond O Cl. Okay, I can write the name of this compound in two different ways. One by including this particular carbon in the parent chain, and the other by not including this particular carbon in the parent chain. मतलब क्या है? If I am including this carbon, because include किया तो आपको longest carbon chain 3 मिलेगा, 1, 2, 3 होगा. Okay, in that case it is called as थ्री, मतलब प्रोपेन होगा, हुआ ना. इन दैट केस इट इज कॉल्ड एज प्रोपेनोइल हैलाइड. थ्री कार्बन इज प्रोपेन प्लस द फंक्शनल ग्रुप इज ऑयल हैलाइड. ओ वाई एल, ऑयल हैलाइड. व्हेनेवर यू हैव टू ओवल्स कमिंग साइड बाय साइड, ई एंड ओ आर टू ओवल्स, राइट? ए आई ओ यू आर ओवल्स. If you have two ovals coming side by side, always drop the first oval. So you will be calling this as propanoyl halide, or in this case it is propanoyl chloride. Okay, ye naming kab hai? If I am including this particular carbon, the functional group carbon, in the parent chain. If I am not including the functional group carbon in the parent chain, tab kya hoga? Again, I'm taking the same molecule, CH3, CH2, C double bond O, Cl. Take this as first carbon, this as second carbon. ऐसा भी लिख सकता हूँ, but the most appropriate will be this, because this will be the longest carbon chain, three carbons. I can also write by not including that particular carbon in the parent chain. If I'm not including it, in that case, this will be called as, ये जो part है, alkane. So this is ethane, and you need to write that as carbonyl halide. Ethane carbonyl chloride. देखो, by not including the carbon, आपको एक carbon की deficit हुआ ना. So यहाँ पे इसलिए इसके name में carb करके आ रहा है. This carb indicates it is made up of carbon. Ethane carbonyl chloride. In total, you will be having three carbons. Ethane में दो carbons है, carbonyl में carbon है, carbonyl chloride. Let us understand what is the purpose for having these two names. Why are we writing the name by including the carbon as well as by not including the carbon? Usually, a not including the carbon case जो है, it arises in case of cyclic compounds. whenever you have a cyclic compound, this is a cyclic compound, यहाँ पे आपको C double bond O Cl है. Starting में nomenclature के starting में आपको एक point लिखा. Rule number one में everyone observe. In rule number one, if there is a cyclic structure present, the longest chain starts and stops within the cyclic structure. Please observe this point. If there is a cyclic structure present, the longest chain starts and stops within the cyclic structure. इसका मतलब क्या है? In this case, you are having a cyclic structure. You should not do numbering in this way. यहाँ पे मान देखे इसको 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 ये नहीं करना है. According to the rule, what we need to do is, whenever you are starting the numbering, you need to start numbering as well as stop numbering within the ring. Okay, यहाँ पे start किया तो वो जो numbering end हो रहे, it is ending inside the ring. Whenever you have cyclic structure, you need to start and stop numbering within the ring. Is that clear? So हम करेंगे क्या इसके लिए? You will do numbering from here. यहाँ से start करेंगे because that C double bond of Cl is the functional group. उसको lowest possible number आना चाहिए. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 In this particular case, I am unable to include the carbon in the parent chain. If I am unable to include the carbon in the parent chain, I cannot write the name as oil halide. इसलिए two types of naming हर किसी चीज के लिए है. Two types of naming. One type of naming says that if I am able to include the carbon in the parent chain, I will be writing that as oil halide. And the other type of naming is, if I am unable to include the carbon in the parent chain, I will be writing that as carbonyl halide. एक बार ये observe करना, why I am writing that as carbonyl, because one of the carbon is left out. In order to include that carbon, the name is having carbon. Okay, carbonyl halide. Any doubt? So इसका नाम क्या हो जाएगा बताओ? This will be called as cyclohexane carbonyl chloride. Cyclohexane carbonyl chloride. और एक important point, in this particular case में no need to give the number one, because if you are having only one functional group and if this is the major functional group, whenever you do numbering according to the rules, this will be given one, right? इसी के ऊपर वन स्टार्ट करने वाला. नो नीड टू सेपरेटली मेंशन साइक्लोहेक्सेन वन कार्बोनिल क्लोराइड फर्स्ट कार्बन के ऊपर है करके. उल्टा सोचो. उल्टा सोचने का मतलब क्या है? साइक्लोहेक्सेन करके बोल रहे हैं, ठीक है, साइक्लोहेक्सेन ड्रॉ किया, कार्बोनिल क्लोराइड करके बोल रहे हैं. इसके ऊपर कहीं पे भी आप सी डबल बॉन्ड और सीएल लगाओ, वही कॉम्पाउंड मिलेगा ना. डू यू नीड टू नो the position of the carbon 1, 2, 3, 4 ये सब जरूरत ही नहीं है ना. किस जिस कार्बन के ऊपर C double bond और Cl लगाऊंगा, that will become the first carbon. Any doubt anyone? Okay. So ये जो table है, we will be exploring this table as we solve questions. How to understand this table? How to study this table? Any particular functional groups can have two different names. If it is the principal functional group, it will be written in the suffix. उसमें भी दो types of naming हो सकता है. One is by including the carbon and other is by not including the carbon. If I am not including the carbon, this will be called as carbonyl halide. If I am including this, it will be called as oil halide. Okay, clear है? Okay. If it is written in the prefix, this will be called as halocarbonyl. In the prefix, this will be written as halocarbonyl. Similarly, others भी देख लेते हैं. Alcohols, if it is the major functional group, it will be ending with all. यहाँ पे हमको करना क्या है? You need to add the alkane part to all. Alkane plus all, it will be alkanol. Alkane plus all, ये all these things are suffixes. After the unsaturation index, you will be adding the suffix ना. Unsaturation index. Suppose if it is an alkane, alkane plus all. This will be written as, again you need to drop the first vowel, alkanol. Any doubt? यहाँ पे क्या हो जाएगा? This is alkane plus carbaldehyde. C is not a noble, so don't drop that E part. This will be alkane carbaldehyde. Okay. If it is written by including the carbon, it is called as alkane plus al. It will be alkanal. Any doubt? Anyone? Alkane plus al, alkanal. You need to drop the first vowel E. Aaya na samajh mein? Okay, good. So explore karenge. Ye samajh mein aaya na? This bracket wala part and without bracket wala part. Bracket wala part matlab I am including the carbon in the parent chain. If it is not present in the parent chain, I will be writing this as carbaldehyde. If it is part of the parent chain, I will be writing this as al. I hope this is clear. Aage bade. On the go, we will explore this table. Question dekhenge, us question ke hisab se kya use karenge, dekhte hain. Okay. इसमें डिफरेंट डिफरेंट फंक्शनल ग्रुप्स दिया है. अमाइड्स सी डबल बॉन्ड NH2, अमाइन्स NH2, कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड COH, ईथर्स OR और ROR, ये तरह का अल्केल पार्ट रहेगा ROR, एस्टर्स सी डबल बॉन्डो OR, कीटोन्स सी डबल बॉन्डो, इस साइड एक अल्केल ग्रुप रहेगा, इस साइड एक अल्केल ग्रुप रहेगा. साइनाइड्स और नाइट्राइल्स, साइनाइड्स आर द मोस्ट कॉमनली कॉल्ड इन ऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री, दे आर कॉल्ड एज नाइट्राइल्स. Cyanide is an inorganic name, but in organic chemistry they are referred to as nitriles. Yehi yaad rakhna, nitrile, which is RC triple bond and sulfonic acids RSO3H, thiols RSH. Whenever you see the name thio, replace the oxygen with sulfur. If it is alcohol, it is OH. If it is thiol, it is SH. Okay. Clear?
Sir, can you repeat the last point?
Whenever you see the name thio indicates sulfur. Alcohol hai to OH rehta hai. Thiol matlab replace the O with sulfur, you will be having SH. Thiol. Okay? That written in suffix, it is called named as thiol. If it is written in prefix, it is called as sulfonyl. Sulfa, A hai ye. Sulfonyl. Okay. So हमने स्टार्टिंग में एक पॉइंट लिखा, इफ यू आर हैविंग मोर देन वन फंक्शनल ग्रुप, ओनली वन इज ट्रीटेड एज द प्रिंसिपल फंक्शनल ग्रुप, रेस्ट ऑल अदर ट्रीटेड एज सब्स्टिट्यूएंट्स. सो यू नीड टू नो द प्रायोरिटी ऑर्डर फॉर द डिफरेंट फंक्शनल ग्रुप्स, तभी हम ये जज कर पाएंगे विच इज द मेजर फंक्शनल ग्रुप, विच इज द सेकेंडरी फंक्शनल ग्रुप. सो दिस इज द प्रायोरिटी ऑर्डर, COH ग्रेटर दैन SO3H ग्रेटर दैन COR ग्रेटर दैन COCl, CONH2, CN, CHO, कीटोन, alcohol, thiol, amine, C double bond C, alkene and alkyne. Alkene is given more priority. Once please concentrate here. Alkene is given more priority when compared to alkyne, if and only if they are in equivalent positions. मतलब क्या है? ऐसा कुछ है हमारे पास C double bond C, C, C triple bond C. They are in equivalent positions. मतलब left hand side से numbering and right hand side से numbering कुछ फर्क नहीं पड़ रहा है. उस पर्टिकुलर केस में लेफ्ट हैंड साइड से नंबरिंग स्टार्ट करूंगा, अल्किन से स्टार्ट करूंगा, बिकॉज़ अल्किन जो है इट स्टार्ट्स विद ई, अल्काइन जो है इट स्टार्ट्स विद वाई. ई कम्स फर्स्ट इन अल्फाबेटिकल लिस्टिंग. इन केस वैसा नहीं है कंपाउंड, ऐसा कुछ है. देखो सी बॉन्ड सी डबल बॉन्ड ट्रिपल बॉन्ड. इस केस में अल्किन को ही ज्यादा प्रायोरिटी दूंगा बिकॉज उसको लोएस्ट नंबर आता है ना. लेफ्ट टू राइट स्टार्ट किया तो द नंबर ऑन अल्किन इज 2, राइट टू लेफ्ट स्टार्ट किया तो द फर्स्ट नंबर इज 1. ओके, अल्काइन के ऊपर नंबर वन आ रहा है. इस केस में राइट टू लेफ्ट दूंगा बिकॉज आई एम फॉलोइंग दैट लोएस्ट नंबर, द फंक्शनल ग्रुप शुड गेट लोएस्ट पॉसिबल नंबर. आई विल बी गिविंग मोर प्रायोरिटी टू अल्किन इफ एंड ओनली इफ दे आर इन इक्विवेलेंट पोजीशंस. इज दैट क्लियर? ओके, द अदर प्रायोरिटी ऑर्डर इज सबसे ज्यादा कार्बोक्सिलिक एसिड. अगेन यू नीड टू रिमेंबर दिस ऑर्डर. वन कैन रिमेंबर दिस ऑर्डर ओनली बाय सॉल्विंग मोर एंड मोर क्वेश्चंस. जितना ज्यादा क्वेश्चंस करेंगे, बार बार आप इस टेबल को रेफर करेंगे, आपको समझ में आएगा. ओके, अगर COCl है, CN है, दोनों है, देन COCl विल बी टेकन एज द मेजर फंक्शनल ग्रुप, CN विल बी टेकन एज द सेकेंडरी फंक्शनल ग्रुप. सो CN जो है इट विल बी रिटन इन सफिक्स, सॉरी CN जो है इट विल बी रिटन इन प्रीफिक्स बिकॉज दिस इज सेकेंडरी फंक्शनल ग्रुप. COCl जो है दिस विल बी रिटन इन द सफिक्स. सो नेम्स कैसे हो जाएगा? as this is written in prefix, this will be written as cyano. As this is written in suffix, this will be written as either oil halide by including the carbon, by not including the carbon, carbonyl halide. Any doubt? Any doubt, anyone? Okay, kuch questions karna dekhte hai. Before that, there are some groups which are always treated as substituents. You should never treat them as functional groups, like alkyl group. Alkyl group is the substituent. C6H5 matlab kya ho gaya? It is called as phenyl. This is benzene, whose formula is C6H6. If you are replacing one of the hydrogen and you are making that as substituent, this is called as phenyl. C6H5 is always treated as substituent. Is that clear? And the name of it is phenyl. NO2, it is also a substituent, not a functional group, which is called as nitro. OR, this is also a substituent, which is called as alkoxy. Dekho, ROH jo hai, it is called as alcohol. Uske andar se H hata diya to, this substituent is called as alkoxy, which is also treated as substituent always. Any doubt, anyone? Halogens are also substituents. Clear hai? Okay. If there is more than one functional group of the same type, then we use the prefix di, tetra, etc. Okay? Chalo, names dekhte hai. Everyone, concentrate. If you want 2 minutes break, we can take 2 minutes break. You want 2 minutes break? Okay, see the first example. You are having carboxylic acid and you are having only one functional group in here. So this will be the major functional group. If this is a major functional group, this will be written in the suffix. Let us see COH ke liye suffix mein kaise likhte hai. Carboxylic acid kahan pe hai? Yahan pe dekho. COH in the suffix can be written as either carboxylic acid or oic acid. Carboxylic acid karke kab likhenge? Whenever I am not including the carbon in the parent chain. If I am including the carbon in the parent chain, I need to write that as oic acid. Okay. So, is particular context mein dekhna, I can include the carbon in the parent chain. If I am including that, the compound root is pent. The unsaturation index is alkane plus the suffix is oic acid. You are getting two ovals side by side. Hence, I am dropping the first oval. So this will be called as pentanoic acid. If I don't want to include the carbon in the parent chain, tab kya hoga? 1, 2, 3, 4. This will be butane, one carboxylic acid. Yahan pe ye observe karna, I'm writing the number 1. The reason for that is, if I'm not including this carbon, ye jo COH jo hai, if it is coming on the second carbon, then it will be butane, 2 carboxylic acid. Yahan pe dekho. This particular example, I am taking this as the parent chain. I am not including this carbon in the parent chain. 1, 2, 3, 4. This case, mein second carbon ke upar COH hai. This case, mein first carbon ke upar COH hai. So there is a choice for the COH on different carbon atoms. Hence, I need to mention this 1 and 2. This will be butane 2 carboxylic acid. Agar isko include kar raha to, if I am including this particular carbon in the parent chain, and if this is the only functional group, obviously, I will be starting number from this carbon. Na. Carboxylic acid jo hai, observe karna. Carboxylic acid jo hai, it can either come at the start or it can come at the end. End ka matlab kya hai, if I am having 2 carboxylic acids. Aisa kuch hai. Ab kya ho rahe? If I am including this carbon in the parent chain, obviously, main isko hi one dene wala hun. Carboxylic acid, either it will start or it will be ending. So, 1 ye hua, 2, 3, 4, 5. If you are having 2 carboxylic acids, carboxylic acid functional group jo hai, it can make only one bond. Okay. COH hai, a carbon ko, C double bond O, OH. This carbon can form only one bond. So, either it will be coming at the start or it will be ending. If I am including both of these carboxylic acids in the parent chain, I will be writing this as pentane dioic acid. Everyone, iska naam kya hoga? दिस इज पेंटेन डाइओइक एसिड. आई एम नॉट ड्रॉपिंग दिस ई पार्ट. रीजन इज दिस इज डी एंड दिस इज ई. दिस टू आर नॉट टू वोवेल्स. हेंस आई एम नॉट ड्रॉपिंग इन दिस केस पेंटेन डाइओइक एसिड. And no need to mention that as pentane 1,5 dioic acid because carboxylic acid obviously वो start और ending पे ही आएगा. उल्टा सोचो एक बार everyone. Pentane का मतलब क्या हुआ? पांच carbons हुआ. Dioic acid मतलब क्या है? You need to have two carboxylic acids. You don't have any choice. You need to put one carboxylic acid here. You need to put the another carboxylic acid here. कुछ choice ही नहीं है. No need to specially mention 1,5. जरूरत ही नहीं है. समझ में आ रहे वो वाला पॉइंट? I cannot have a carboxylic acid here. Double bond O SOH. This is not carboxylic acid. This is an invalid structure. Carbon cannot make 5 bonds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 bonds हो गया ना? I hope that particular statement is clear to you. Whenever you are having carboxylic acid, either it can come at the start or at the end, provided you are including the carbon of the carboxylic acid. यहाँ पे क्या हुआ? You are not including the carbon. इसलिए आपको specially mention करना पड़ेगा ये carboxylic acid आपको first carbon के ऊपर है या second carbon के ऊपर है. यहाँ पे include नहीं किया आपने. First carbon के ऊपर है या second carbon के ऊपर है. If I am including the carbon of the carboxylic acid. If it is the only functional group, obviously इसको ही वन देने वाला हूँ. So no need to mention that number as one. Extra information हो गया ना, इसको ही वन देने वाला हूँ ना. समझ में आया आपको? So this will be 2-methylbutanoic acid. Directly you can write it as butanoic acid. No need to mention 2-methylbutan-1-oic acid. Is that clear? If I'm having two carboxylic acids, if I'm including both of them. I can say directly pentane dioic acid. No need to say pentane 1,5 dioic acid. That 1 and 5 is extra information. If I give you pentane dioic acid, if you try to form the compound, you will arrive at this. No need to mention that 1,5. It is a redundant information, extra information. Aaya samajh mein? Aage badho? Okay. यहाँ पे देखो, this is the cyclic compound, hence I need to start and stop numbering within the cyclic compound. So यहाँ से one start किया, I am unable to include the carbon in the parent chain here, so I will be writing the name as carboxylic acid. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it is cyclohexane carboxylic acid. No position is required to be mentioned if only one substituent is present. क्योंकि obviously उसको ही one देने वाला. Any doubt anyone? Okay, take some time, try to solve these questions. First solve the first 5 questions. We will discuss first 5. The remaining of the questions you can take them as homework. We will discuss in the next lecture. Nahi, lecture 10:40 tak hai na, bhul gaya main. You can solve all of the questions. First solve first 5 questions. We will discuss. देवाशीष को चला गया वो. Can I discuss starting the questions? In the first question, can you tell me the major functional group present?
C double bond OH.
C double bond OH, which is nothing but aldehyde.
Aldehyde.
Okay. So numbering kis side se karenge, left to right or right to left?
Left to right.
Very good. यहाँ पे one होगा, ये two होगा, ये three होगा, ये four होगा. I'm including the carbon. If you are able to include the carbon, always include the carbon. जब भी आप लोग include नहीं कर पाते हैं, then only write the name without including the carbon. Okay? याद रखना है. Okay. So include करते हुए, so this will be butte. The unsaturation index is butte. Sorry, the compound root is butte. The unsaturation index is alkene, and it is coming on the second carbon, butte 2-ene plus al hoga. Whenever you are having two ovals side by side, you will be dropping the first oval, so it will be called as 2-butte. Sorry, butte 2-enal. Again, aldehyde jo hai, it will be coming either on the first carbon or on the last carbon. As you are including this carbon, obviously इसको ही first देने वाला हूँ ना, so no need to specify the number one for aldehyde here. So simply it is butte-2-enal. Any doubt, anyone? So, okay. Next question. Next question. What is the functional group we have? Ketone. Numbering 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is pent. The unsaturation index is alkane, so it will be pentane. You will be having two ovals side by side, so I am dropping the first oval, pentan, 3-one. Any doubt? If it is a ketone, it will be written as one. यहाँ पे देखो, if it is a major functional group, suffix में it will be written as one. One बोलना है, one नहीं है ये, one. Okay? So it is pentan-3-one. Any doubt? Similarly, this will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This will be pentan-2-one. This will be pentan-2-one. Okay? And यहाँ पे aldehyde है. This will be called as pentanal.
So sheet is the you already said that okay. हाँ. अत लापने वाले तो.
एक मिनट. So this will be pentanal. No need to give the number one because obviously इसके ऊपर ही one रहेगा. Aldehyde भी either it can come at the start or at the end. Okay. Okay. इस question का answer. Tell me the answer. Answer please.
Pentine 3 all.
Pentine 3 kya?
Pentine 3 one all.
Pentine 3 one all. Pentine 3 one all kya hai? Pent 3 ion hota hai. Pentine 3 kya hai?
Pent 3 ion.
कोई सीक्रेट सर्विस का नेम है क्या? पेंटाइन थ्री नहीं है, पेंट थ्री आइन वन ऑल. द फंक्शनल ग्रुप, मेजर फंक्शनल ग्रुप इज अल्कोहल, सो यहाँ पे आपको वन देना पड़ेगा. ये टू, ये थ्री, ये फोर, ये फाइव. ऑन द थर्ड कार्बन यू आर हैविंग अल्काइन, सो पहले उसका पोजीशन मेंशन करना है. और यू कैन राइट दैट एज 3-pentyne और यू कैन राइट दैट एज पेंट 3-ion. पेंटाइन 3 नहीं है, ये गलत है. Okay, pent 3-ion. Again, oval, two ovals coming side by side. So, why any likhenge? Pent 3-ion. And you need to mention the position of alcohol because ये जो OH है, ये second carbon के ऊपर भी रह सकता था. Second carbon के ऊपर रहा तो it will be pent 3-ion 2-ol होगा. Third carbon पे ऊपर रहा तो third carbon यहाँ पे नहीं होगा. In case third carbon के ऊपर रहा तो it will be 3-ol, so on so forth. You need to mention the position of OH, क्योंकि OH के लिए ऐसा तो नहीं है, it always comes on the first carbon. जरूरत नहीं है ना, समझ में आया? सो इट विल बी पेंट थ्री आइन वन ऑल. नेक्स्ट अल्कोहल इज द मेजर फंक्शनल ग्रुप, वन टू थ्री फोर फाइव. This will be called as
4-bromo.
Oh, sorry, substituent, na? So you are having 4-bromo. Very good.
2-butenol.
2-butene-1-ol. Again, you need to mention the position of alcohol. वो first carbon के ऊपर है, second carbon के ऊपर रहा तो two ol होगा. So you can write this as 2-butene-1-ol. Okay, so or else I can write this as but-2-ene. Me again, I will be dropping that e because e and o are coming side by side. So 4-bromo but-2-ene-1-ol. Any doubt? Okay, in this case you are having two functional groups. One is the carboxylic acid and other is ketone. Carboxylic acid is the major functional group, so wahan se numbering karenge and I am including that. So oic acid karke likhna padega. Ketone ka, if I am writing that as the prefix, kya aayega?
Oxo.
Oxo. So this will be 3-oxo.
Oxo butanoic acid.
Butanoic acid. Don't need to mention that one here, क्योंकि obviously इसको ही बंद देने वाला. इसका ये दूसरा नाम भी कभी-कभी ये भी दिखता है आपको. You can also write this as 3-keto. Sometimes it is written as keto. Oxo is the most appropriate one, but कभी-कभी keto करके भी उसको refer करते हैं. 3-keto butanoic acid. Okay. Okay. Eighth question, answer anyone? Samarjeet, can you tell me the answer for 8? Answer for 8? Dhruv. Dhruv, answer for 8.
Propane. 1-2-3-ol.
1-2-3-ol nahi, triol. Teen hai na, triol. Sahi hai.
Yes.
Propane 1, 2, 3 triol. Ye 1, 2, 3. Everyone concentrate. Propane. Yaha pe aapko teen substituents hai. 1, 2, 3 triol. Okay. Rajin, ninth question. Yeah, Vanshika, ninth question. Vanshika, ninth question. Neil Patel. Ninth. What disturbance are there?
Yes, sir.
या इट्स ओके, मुझे थोड़ा लैग हो रहा है. इट इज यहाँ पे वन है, टू है, थ्री है, फोर है, दिस इज फाइव. Whenever you are having COH, either it can come at the start or at the end. You are having two COH, you are including both the things. So obviously already इसके बारे में अभी discuss किया हमने. This will be simply pentane dioic acid. Pentane dioic acid. No need to mention that one and five. क्योंकि obvious है वो starting पे आएगा, ending में आएगा. Hexane dioic acid मतलब first carbon पे एक COH है, last carbon पे एक COH है. Okay. Tenth question. Yeah. Anyone? Harshada, 10th question.
So, 1, 2, 3, propane carboxylic acid.
Very good. It is 1, 2, 3 or propane 1, 2, 3 tricarboxylic acid, or it is 1, 2, 3 propane tricarboxylic acid, or it is propane 1, 2, 3 tricarboxylic acid. कुछ लोग ऐसा कुछ किया होगा, everyone. Maybe ये one, ये टू, ये थ्री, ये फोर, ये फाइव लेके थ्री कार्बोक्सी थर्ड पोजिशन पे वो सब्स्टिट्यूएंट जैसा मान के COH इज कार्बोक्सी राइट, थ्री कार्बोक्सी पेंटेन डायोइक एसिड, पेंटेन डायोइक एसिड. किसी ने ये किया?
यस सर.
ओके ओके, किया होगा. ये गलत है, ये नहीं करना चाहिए. द रीजन इज इफ all of them are COH, all of them are the primary functional groups, you should not treat ek ko zyada priority deke dusre ko kam priority nahi dena chahiye, sabko equal priority dena chahiye. Iska matlab kya hua, main teeno ko include nahi kar pa raha, do ko include kar pa raha hu na, so write the name without including all the three. Yahan pe 1 2 3 karke mention karke you will be writing this name. This is most appropriate. Any doubt? ओके या 11th क्वेश्चन तो कर लिया होगा. दिस इज 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. OH इज द सब्स्टिट्यूएंट. इफ OH इज सब्स्टिट्यूएंट इट इज रिटन एज 3-hydroxy pentane dioic acid. 3-hydroxy pentane dioic acid. Any doubt? ओके गुड. डायरेक्ट आसान है. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. दिस इज 5-oxo पेंटेनोइक एसिड. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. सॉरी, हेक्सेनोइक एसिड. दिस इज 6-oxo हेक्सेनोइक एसिड. 6 कार्बन पे ऊपर सी डबल बॉन्ड है ना. एल्डिहाइड के लिए भी ऑक्सो ही बोलते हैं. यहाँ पे देखना आप लोग, ऑब्जर्व इन एल्डिहाइड्स आल्सो वी कॉल दैट एज ऑक्सो, इन कीटोन्स आल्सो वी कॉल दैट एज ऑक्सो. इन एल्डिहाइड्स इफ आई एम अनेबल टू इंक्लूड द कार्बन इट इज कॉल्ड एज फॉर्मिल. ऐसा क्वेश्चन करेंगे हम, प्रैक्टिस जब करेंगे तब समझ में आ जाएगा किसको कहाँ पे यूज करना है. Clear everyone? These 13 questions. The 13 questions may 10th question important hai. If I am unable to include all the COH, don't do that. Ek ko COH, ek COH ko aap substituent maan ke baaki COH ko functional group. Ye maanna galat hoga. Okay? Okay.
So,
thank you everyone.